Water intrusion are water damaged building materials, say from a flood, from a pipe break, from a dishwasher overflow in a home, or you have condensation on windowsills. You have unusual moisture on building materials. The low concentrations of naturally occurring fungi now will use that moisture to grow, and they'll grow to large numbers. And some of these fungi that can cause adverse human health effects grow rapidly in indoor environments to large numbers. They get dispersed by normal human activity, and then there's exposure to the building occupants. When these molds are growing indoors on wet building materials, they're often using the cellulose that's in those building materials. Perhaps it's the ceiling tile that are cellulose. It's using the paper backing on gypsum wallboard. It doesn't use the gypsum inside the sandwich. It's using the paper on either side as a food source. Sometimes they're using wallpaper or the mastic behind the wallpaper as a food source. It could be using the dirt and dust that's present on bookshelves or other parts of the office environment as a nutrient source. When they're outdoors, molds are very common in soil or on plant leaves and trees. I mean, if you think about it, fungi's natural job on the planet is to recycle. They're the penultimate recyclers. Their entire purpose for being here is to take dead leaves and trees, turn it into carbon back in the soil so we can have new leaves and trees. When it's growing indoors, it doesn't recognize the fact that that's a 2x4 or 2x6 or a piece of ceiling tile. It just sees it as a nutrient source. Water intrusion are water damaged building materials, say from a flood, from a pipe break, from a dishwasher overflow in a home, or you have condensation on windowsills. You have unusual moisture on building materials. The low concentrations of naturally occurring fungi now will use that moisture to grow, and they'll grow to large numbers. And some of these fungi that can cause adverse human health effects grow rapidly in indoor environments to large numbers. They get dispersed by normal human activity, and then there's exposure to the building occupants. When these molds are growing indoors on wet building materials, they're often using the cellulose that's in those building materials. Perhaps it's the ceiling tile that are cellulose. It's using the paper backing on gypsum wallboard. It doesn't use the gypsum inside the sandwich. It's using the paper on either side as a food source. Sometimes they're using wallpaper or the mastic behind the wallpaper as a food source. It could be using the dirt and dust that's present on bookshelves or other parts of the office environment as a nutrient source. When they're outdoors, molds are very common in soil or on plant leaves and trees. I mean, if you think about it, fungi's natural job on the planet is to recycle. They're the penultimate recyclers. Their entire purpose for being here is to take dead leaves and trees, turn it into carbon back in the soil so we can have new leaves and trees. When it's growing indoors, it doesn't recognize the fact that that's a 2x4 or 2x6 or a piece of ceiling tile. It just sees it as a nutrient source.